The Bishop of Rwenzori Diocese, the Right Reverend Reuben Kisembo, has made a clarion call to the people of Toro Kingdom to forgive John Sanyu Katuramu, describing him as a reformed man. John Sanyu Katuramu was jailed more than 20 years ago after he was convicted of the murder of Prince Kija Nangoma. Bishop Kisembo becomes the first opinion leader to speak on Katuramu's release, whose eventual release from a prison has led to comments from across the kingdom on how he can be part of a new generation of reformists.
And he comes out as a reformed person. Let us welcome him, let us forgive him, because we are all sinners, many of all us are sinners, and we should receive him back into society.
The Bishop of Rwenzori Diocese, Right Reverend Reuben Kisembo, thanked God for keeping Katuramu alive while in prison for 20 years. Bishop Kisembo said although Katuramu committed a crime, the criminality in him has now been crushed. He is now a reformed person.
Whoever has not sinned should be the first to cast the first stone. At the end of the day, yes, everything that comes down, everything that comes down, but these are the same words that God is speaking to a brother out of prison.
The Toro Kingdom Prime Minister has said as the son of Toro, Katuramu is welcome. He added that in case of any other underlying issues, they will be resolved. Hassan Kato, a member of the Katuramu family, said his relative's release has been long overdue. Kato said as a family, they thank God that Katuramu has completed his jail sentence and come out in good health. He, however, regretted that while in prison, Katuramu lost so many people, including his biological parents, whom he did not get chance to bury.
The father and the mother died when he was in jail, but all in all, that was God's plan, and his back and as people, the village where he grew from, as part of the family members, they're really happy.
Kato said Toro has a lot of hope in Katuramu now that he is out of jail. Kenneth Ikoje, a businessman in Fort Poto, said as a young generation, they're excited about the release of Katuramu.
We have now a regional city, Fort Poto to a regional city, that needs people like John Sanyu Katuramu, people who are critical thinkers, people who can add development to our city.
Katuramu was convicted in 2001 together with two others over murder. The news has learned that two separate houses, one in Bunyangabo district and the other in Chenjojo district, have been built for Katuramu as he returns home. His family says he is yet to choose where he will permanently settle. Story by Roger Sunday for the news.